Hello, welcome back, and thank you as always for joining me. You'll notice here right off that the word manifesting is in the title. It appears in the title of this discussion today. So, what this will not be about is about manifesting money. It will not be about manifesting a bigger, stronger, sleeker, more attractive looking physical body. Because what body? It will not be about manifesting a new car or an extra couple of digits in your bank account. It will not be about any popular manifestation at all. Will that stuff happen to you along the way? Maybe. Perhaps you're enjoying that now. Perhaps not. Perhaps your life has been a wild succession of ups and downs in all of those arenas, which I suspect, because that's what happens to all of us. We're going to talk today instead about manifesting truth. Truth. And if you're following along, we're covering four very powerful paragraphs in chapter 12, section 7 of the text of A Course in Miracles, specifically paragraphs 12 through 15, which wrap up this section. And I do invite you to consult these, whether you've got a physical copy of the course or whether you read it online. Jesus tells us right at the start of paragraph 12, when you look within and see me, it will be because you have decided to manifest truth. When you look within and see me, it will be because you have decided to manifest truth. Decided to manifest truth. Let that sit. Let this idea percolate in your mind. The very important component here is decision, which, as we saw in the last video, is the one remaining freedom that we have here in this world. And it is enough. It is more than enough for us to set all of this drama aside. For all time. It's more than enough. So let's exercise this power of choice and choose to manifest truth. What does this actually look like? That's a great question. It means decide to share the Holy Spirit with your brother. Share Jesus with your brother. Share love with your brother. Share, extend, share, extend. Love, the love of God, love in general, is not a physical thing. It's completely abstract, isn't it? It's highly intangible. It's an idea. It's an idea. And the important part here, something that's very critical for us to understand here on the spiritual path, is that ideas strengthen as they're given away. As you share an idea, you strengthen it in your mind and in the mind of the recipients. Ideas gain in strength as they're shared, as they're given away. Want the peace of God, give the peace of God. Want love, give love. Make the decision to share, share, share. Decide to share it. You'll share it. What then happens is what you see will be radically different than what you saw before. We've seen in this very section of the text how our perception, in fact, works, is that we invite something in our mind, invite truth in your mind. You then expect truth. Expecting truth, you then see truth. Invite love. Expect love. See love. Invite truth. Expect truth. See truth. So the question is what you've decided to make manifest. How about the love of God? How about truth? We're invited, after all, to want the peace of God and nothing else. When we invite the peace of God, we then expect, quite naturally, expect the peace of God, which we then see. And as always, my hope is that you'll begin to appreciate how powerful you really are. I mean, Jesus has complete faith and confidence in you. The Holy Spirit has complete faith and confidence in you that you can do this. He did. He'll show you how. All we have to do is accept that guidance. So as we continue in this section, paragraph 13 talks about the sheer savagery of the ego. I invite you to read it. The ego wants to kill you. It's enough to simply know that. It's savage. It's fear itself, and it is brutal, it's deceptive, it's crazy, it's very crazy. So read that, because there's no need to say any more than that here. So understand something about the ego. It's a simple mistake. It's a mistake. It's not real. It itself is illusion. But we give our faith and confidence and allegiance to it. It's not a traitor to God. That, in fact, is impossible. There is only perfect oneness. God doesn't know treachery. He doesn't know what that even is. That's something we've made up. It's impossible that anything or anyone could be treacherous to God. Why? That's duality. It would imply that something's separate from God and exists separately from God and could betray him. Impossible. Absolutely, forever, eternally impossible. The ego is, however, a traitor to you. It makes you think that you've been treacherous to God, that you took the apple, ate it, and were thrown out of the garden, in a manner of speaking. It makes you think that you have betrayed God. You have not. That is, again, impossible. Yet, believing the ego, having sided with it, having adopted it as our teacher and guide, we suffer guilt. There is in each of us an enormous well, a vast sea, if you will, of unconscious guilt. So the undoing of guilt stems from our mistaken belief that we've separated from God, which is, of course, impossible, but because we believe we have, we see separation everywhere and we experience guilt everywhere. Now, you may not see yourself as someone who feels guilty all of the time, but this guilt shows up in many different ways. Anything that's not wholly joyous is a symbol, it's a way that this guilt shows up in our lives. Sadness, regret and fear. Anytime you're ill at ease or in a fit of rage or anything in between, anything that's not wholly joyous is an opportunity for forgiveness. This is most definitely part of the Holy Spirit's teaching for us, the undoing of guilt. We're undoing the ego. We've not been treacherous to God. That's impossible. We've never left our source. Ideas leave not their source. You are the thought of God. Thoughts remain in the mind of the thinker. Ideas leave not their source. You've never left. We've never left. So it's very powerful for us to forgive. It's very powerful for us to decide to share the Holy Spirit with our brother. It's very powerful for us to decide to extend love, which strengthens as we give it away. Paragraph 15. There's some language here about death and how the ego is savage and wants to kill us. Yeah, and right at the outset, Jesus reminds us of something. He says, I did not die. It's in italics for emphasis here. I did not die. Remember, we're not a physical body. We can do whatever we want to our physical bodies or someone else's physical body. We can drive nails through its hands and hang it from a cross or anything else. That's not who we are. Because ideas leave not their source. We've never left our source. This is Jesus teaching us that ideas leave not their source, that you are not a body. Of course he did not die. There is no death. The Son of God is free. This is an idea in the workbook for students, if you've never heard this before. Gosh, and if you've never heard this conversation before and you're just happening along because YouTube recommended this to you, well, welcome. You've watched to this point, so you're gathering. This is very, very deep. I invite you, as Jesus invites us, to question everything. But don't stop simply at questioning this talking head on your screen, which is nothing more than an assemblage of dots. It's a pixelated image. Something has landed for you to still be watching this. It's your inner teacher speaking to you. There's a message here that has hit home for you somehow. I don't know what that is, but you do. So I invite you to pay particular attention to that. There's a reason why you're here today. When you look within and see Jesus, he says this, when you look within first person, because he is the one that has dictated A Course in Miracles, he says, when you look within and see me, in italics, see me, you'll realize it's true that he didn't die. So remember, at the outset of this discussion, we talked about the decision to manifest truth. And what we first see within, we quite naturally then see without. There is nothing out there. The world that we see, that appears to be outside us, is in our mind. We have the choice to see what this course refers to as the real world. In other words, the world forgiven completely. That symbolizes the clarifying of our perception, which is the goal of this course. Beyond seeing things as they really are, learning cannot go. At that point, there's nothing else to learn. Our clarified perception is easily translated into knowledge. It's easily translated into truth, into who we really are, which is beyond perception entirely. This is awakening, which happens naturally, automatically, and instantaneously once we clarify our perception. How do we do this? Well, we exercise our power of decision to manifest truth, to share love with our brother, to extend the miracle of true forgiveness to every living thing. Share these ideas, and they strengthen as they're given away. All right. Nobody ever said that this material was shallow. So in offering this, what's going on here is a recognition that you deserve nothing less than this. If you're interested in A Course in Miracles, it's for a reason. Here's what it's getting at. Ideas leave not their source. That's literal. God is, period, literal. Fact, with a capital F. As in fact, he's known in this course. So again, Let me just echo in closing and wrapping up here something that I mentioned a couple of minutes ago, is that there's a reason why you're here today. So pay particular attention to that. And I invite you to do what your inner teacher suggests you do. Extend love to the Son of God. When you feel less than wholly joyous, in other words, anything other than pure joy and happiness is an opportunity to forgive. So recognize that and do accordingly. Make a decision today to manifest truth. Make a decision today to share the Holy Spirit with your brother. Do just that. All right. So I thank you for tuning in here. These videos have been running now for 3 years. They began as a live stream on Enlightened World Network 3 years ago, in January, in fact. And since then, it has grown and grown, and the number of people watching has grown and grown. It's a growing international community. So if you have not yet subscribed and joined us, we'd love to have you. Please do that. The prompt is here in the corner of your screen. So click that arrow, hover over that arrow there in the corner. You'll be invited to subscribe and join us. So do that. And if you know of people that might be interested in this course, who are curious about A Course in Miracles, let them know too. And as always, questions are always welcome. Comments are always welcome. This is a place by design to have some questions asked and answered and comments exchanged. So even if you just wish to pop in and say hello, I'd love to hear from you. Thank you for tuning in and for joining me here today, and I'll see you again soon.